The title is Counting Shields, so which means we need to produce some number if we want to count something. So the way to one way to produce such number is using cap product. This if we have some cohomology class and homology class on proper space, then we can get some number, rational number here. So using this idea, if you want to count some geometric object, for instance, sheaves or subschemes, satisfying certain restrictions, then we get some number using this procedure. In this talk, I'm only interested in this part, not this part. So here is an example of that philosophy. If we want to count lines on the plane, passing through two arbitrary points in the plane, then we can take M to be modular space of all lines in the plane, which is dual lines, also isomorphic to P2. Then the so we need to describe condition in terms of homology class. So this condition, so one condition is passing through one point. If we describe our modular space M in this way, like you can see this equation, then passing through this point satisfies this condition. So the lines passing through one point, this is described as a hyperplane in P2. So passing through two point means it's scalar. So by capping fundamental class and H2, we get one, so which means the line passing through two points, number of lines passing through two points is one. Here, so in the previous example, we took A, the fundamental class, because we want to, so because this class A must contain all objects we want to count. So this must be nearly fundamental class. But sometimes this is not good choice because this may not be some deformation invariant. Here is an example. So if we see this spaces parameterized by T in A1, so every other some generic subschemes are just four lines. But in the center, this is one line together with one plane, which means the fundamental class of M0 somehow it's not deformation invariant. So the better choice is just four lines. These four lines can be described as the Euler class of vector bundle. But if we take this way, then one problem is caused because the support of Euler class is P3 itself, not M0. So we need to have some machinery to get a class on M. So this is a philosophy. And yeah, I want to introduce some the machine learning to find to define the fundamental class, so-called virtual fundamental class. So let's think about the most simplest case, which is our moduli space M is embedded in smooth space Y, has a zero of some section of vector bound E on Y. So it, the data is described here. Then Fulton and McPherson constructed intersection homomorphism, so denoted by this. This is if we have a class on the Chow group on here, then this the output lies on M, not Y. This is called the refined Euler class. So this has a property that this way. So this refined Euler class composed with push forward by this closed emerger. This is exactly equal to usual Euler class. Then the way to produce some virtual fundamental class is defined by this. So using this operation, refine the Euler class. If we kept this with the fundamental class of this smooth space Y, then we get some class of degree dimension of Y minus rank of E. So in the previous construction, the important we use this embedding. Then we can ask how if we can define fundamental class if there's no such a nice embedding. In this case, Fernando Fantecchi and Li Tian treated this question. They constructed the virtual fundamental class, even though it's not fitted in the diagram previous here. But there's some weaker condition. We need a weaker condition, which means so the moduli, so the space of M's deformation and obstruction spaces should be governed easily. So with this condition, they solved this problem. Yeah, I will explain this exactly. We follow Fernando Fantecchi's definition of perfect obstruction theory. So first, we want to define obstruction theory of M. Obstruction theory of M is a bounded complex whose degree are zero or negative, together with morphism to cotangent complex of M in the derived category of M, such that if those two conditions are satisfied, so the induced homomorphism at zero level must be isomorphism, and minus one level is surjective, then this is called an obstruction theory. Which this is some So roughly speaking, now this complex governs deformation theory. So roughly we can think this gives, this governs deformation space or obstruction space on M. So each, we say this is perfect obstruction theory if this complex F is resolved by locally free sheaves of this two-term complex. This is important. So we have a question?
Yeah, can I have a question?
Yes.
In here, like the cotangent complex already contains the deformation and obstruction of M itself, right? Then why do you
So maybe the whole point is this. So
and the cotangent complex is also locally free sheaf, right, already?
No, that maybe. So
each degree terms are locally free.
I'm not sure then if that is bounded in general.
In general, it's not bounded actually.
Yeah.
So you are saying then we want some kind of bounded replacement.
Yes, yeah, bounded. So, can I keep going?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. If M is equipped with this perfect obstruction theory, F, then we can produce virtual fundamental class using Baron de Fontecchio or Li Tian's machinery. So this is very similar when M fits into the nice diagram we saw before. So we have this similar diagram here. This is the brief idea of the construction. First of all, it's always true. M is fitted in that nice diagram locally. The point here is if we have a perfect obstruction theory, then this local first, because we have this local diagram here, we can sink deformation to the normal cone of M into Y. So here we have such a cone locally. If we have a perfect obstruction theory, then this local cone glues some cone inside this vector bundle on M. So we get some equidimensional cone inside this vector bundle. So we have this diagram, the base space is cone, and along this projection morphism, we have a vector bundle on the cone, and there's a tautological section induced by this diagonal morphism. Then our moduli space M is described as a zero of this tautological section. The only difference compared to previous diagram is now C is not smooth, but this is equidimensional. The point is, the Fulton MacPherson's defined Euler class is defined even when Y is not smooth. So we can do the same machinery. Yeah. Note that the virtual dimension is now rank, the virtual rank. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Did you say that C is smooth?
No, C is not smooth.
Not smooth.
Okay. Here is some example of spaces which has perfect absorption theories. So let's think about the moduli space of maps from projective curve C to smooth projective variety X. With the degree is not important, but I want to say our moduli space is finite time. So this is not important now. So then the deformation, so it's known that the deformation space and obstruction theory spaces are governed by this cohomology, Schiff cohomologies. Classes, Schiff cohomology groups. So the point is, since C is curved, this non-vanish only at 0 and 1. So these two terms governs deformation and obstruction theory, and indeed, this forms a perfect obstruction theory. So the number produced by this procedure is usually called the Gromov-Witten embedded. The other example is a moduli of sheaves. But this the deformation, so if we start with a smooth projective space F to have dimension N, then a perfect deformation and obstruction spaces are governed by fixed groups between 1 and n minus 1. Huibullet Thomas proved actually this gives rise to an obstruction theory. So if n is 3, then this becomes perfect obstruction theory. And the numbers produced in this way is usually called Donaldson-Thomas invariant. If the dimension of X is 4, then X 1, 2, 3 are all governed, these all groups are governed deformation and obstruction spaces. But if X is furthermore, if X is color Biao, then set duality guarantees these conditions. Okay. So our interest is now the counting shifts on this color Biao fourfold X. So let me first define what this color Biao fourfold means exactly. So this X to be color Biao fourfold means it's a smooth projective fourfold with these conditions. And if we fix some Chern class, some cohomology class, such that this condition satisfied, which means so stable shift with the semi-stable shift with the total chunk class C is always stable. So we assume this assumption, then we are interested in the moduli space of stable shifts with the chunk class C. This is today's object. Then one note is now M is projective scheme. With this setup, there are already some works how to produce a bunch of fundamental classes. First introduced by Carl Long and Borisov Joyce later. They constructed a virtual fundamental class with a virtual dimension. So here, all the characteristic of class CC means we can put any element on M instead of C, then this produces constant number. The point is their construction is in a homology group. So I want to introduce now our main theorem. Our main theorem is when virtual dimension is even, then we can construct a virtual fundamental class inside Chow group with this coefficient, this Z1/2 coefficient means ring contains 1/2. So we construct this cycle such that those images here homology group with the Z1/2 coefficient are same. Also, we can construct a virtual virtual structure shift, actually twisted virtual structure shift in K group, also with the Z1/2 coefficient. And they are related by tau map in Q coefficient. More precisely, this the tau map image of this twisted virtual structure shift is exactly this. Here, this is a square root of a Todd class, and this is virtual tangent complex, which is defined to be this first line. So when torus h on our Calabi-Yau fourfold x preserving holomorphic four-form, then we have a localization formula on the moduli level as usual, like this. So I will explain all these terms later. And when virtual dimension is odd, then can prove Borisov Joyce class is zero in this is two-torsion class. So our moduli space was projective, but although this is not projective, if this is quasi projective. It keeps with some torus action, but if this is a compact, the fixed loci is compact, then we can define an invariant using localization formula. The second remark is virtual structure shift must be twisted. If we don't twist, then this is not verified. And for both virtual fundamental class and virtual structure shift, we need one over two in the coefficient. But the region is different. I will explain it. Do you have a question so far? Okay. And now I want to explain the main machinery of our construction. So we mimic some Fulton MacPherson's procedure with this special orthogonal bundle instead of just usual bundle. So you may remember this condition. So the difficulty was now this is three term, x1 and x2, x3. But there's some nice condition, those two. So if you see this, we use only obstruction bundle part. We mimic this procedure with some SOM bundle, special orthogonal bundle here. The special orthogonal, so first, E is orthogonal bundle means it equipped with a symmetric non-degenerate bilinear form. And moreover, if we say this is a special orthogonal bundle, if it is equipped with an orientation. So orientation is an isomorphism of determinant bundle to trivial bundle, such that each square is exactly equal to isomorphism induced by a quadratic form Q.
Oh, excuse me.
Yes.
The previous page, okay, yeah. So here, O is isomorphic, you mean? And O
is, yes. O is isomorphic.
And the last line, the square is also isomorphic?
This is always isomorphic because this is non-degenerate.
But this is O square, right? Determinant E square is O Y, right? Then determinant E is isomorphic O Y, right?
If E is O bundle, then we always have this isomorphism induced by Q. Orientation means, yeah.
Both isomorphism. Okay.
So if E encoded from Q is SO bundle, then this is always decomposed into two bundles as a real bundle. And if we use canonical orientations, then we can check this formula hold. From now on, we assume the SO bundle, the length of SO bundle is even. In this case, Edidin Graham found a lifting of this class. So now it looks a square root of this Euler class up to sign. So known. Somehow it's known this Euler class of E has square root in a homology group. Edidin Graham found the lifting of this square root in Chow group with this coefficient. But this is main reason why we need a 1 over 2 in 4 cycles for virtual fundamental class. Now we we say some vector bundle is sub-bundle is isotropic if this restriction of quadratic form is zero, and if we say this is maximal if its length is just exactly half, and we say this is positive if the isomorphisms has a real bundle from this maximum isotropic to real bundle, preserve the orientation. In that case, we say this lambda is positive maximal isotropic. And the way of editing Gram's construction is to find some cover. So it's not known if this SO bundle E or the maximum isotropic subbundle or not. But the strategy is they constructed some cover on which each pullback has always maximum, so preferred maximum isotropic subbundle. So on the on upstairs, we always have such a canon preferred positive maximum isotropic subbundle. Then use some cohomology, so Chow cohomology class satisfying this condition. They constructed this, and such, and using this they define the scalar Euler class by this formula. Some. So, and they proved this class is lifting over this class in 1/2 coefficient. So this is actually characteristic class, so that it has nice properties. One is if E, so this is not always true, but if E equipped with some maximum isotropic subbundle, then editing Gram's scale to Euler class is equal to Euler class of maximal bundle up to sine. And this sine is plus exactly when F lambda is positive. And also we have some written some formula and deduction things. Reduction is if K is an isotropic subbundle, then this is another SO bundle, this becomes another SO bundle. So orientation is induced by K plus K dual. Using that orientation, we have this formula. Okay. Now, so in the beginning, we use refined Euler class using some section. So now we want to construct some similar thing for editing Gram scale to Euler class. So we do this, we want to do this with some isotropic section. So isotropic means satisfy this condition. Then, as I said, we want to construct some analog of refined Euler class, which means it satisfies this condition. Here is the strategy. So on editing Gram's cover, we have short exact sequence at the bottom of diagram, bottom. Since we are given an isotropic section, each pullback, this is also isotropic. So let S star be this composition. Then on the zero locus of S star, this section induce another section. This only on the zero. So this S tilde this is a section of lambda low on the restriction of jet S star. So then S star dual is somehow, so this homomorphism. Kim and Lee called this is cosection of lambda low dual. And Kim and Lee, in this situation, Kim and Lee constructed an intersection homomorphism, like a Fulton MacPherson's intersection homomorphism. So the Kim and Lee's intersection homomorphism is this, they get some class on the corner of this homomorphism and produce some class on the zero of its dual. They construct this homomorphism to satisfy this diagram. So the here left down is Kim Lee's intersection homomorphism, and right down is Fulton MacPherson homomorphism, intersection homomorphism, and the horizontals are pushed forward, then this commute. So in some sense, so this Kim and Lee's intersection homomorphism is called localized homomorphism of Fulton MacPherson intersection homomorphism. Because we start with the section isotropic, the deformation at the normal cone of the zero of S star to the cover Y tilde is contained in the corner, so that we can use Kim and Lee's intersection homomorphism. Note that the zero of cosection S tilde, section S tilde, is exactly equal to zero of pullback of our isotropic section. So the Kim and Lee's intersection homomorphism can be described this homomorphism. So first, we can take a specialization morphism to from normal cone to from Y tilde to the normal cone. And this composed specialization morphism to Kim and Lee's original homomorphism, then the codomain is Chow group of this. So recall, Edith and Graham defined their scalar Euler class using this formula. Instead, the Euler class, this, we only take Kim and Lee's homomorphism here. The only difference is this. The sign comes from, they use lambda low, but we localize lambda low duals. This is why this sign appeared. Okay. Now we say C, so we want to introduce some isotropic cone. So a cone lies in a vector bundle E over S over under E, whose vertex is Z, which is closed subscheme of Y. In this situation, we say C is the cone is isotropic, means its tautological section is isotropic. So we introduce this is induced by diagonal morphism. So if C is isotropic cone, then we define square root Kissing map, just defined by this, using this bundle, SO bundle, and section. So one note is the domain of this square root Kissing map must be isotropic cone, not E. It's not defined on total space of E. So this square root Kissing map has nice property as what editing Gram class has. If E has a maximum isotropic lambda, then this square root Kissing map is usual Kissing map up to sign. And this the sign plus is equivalent to lambda is positive. And this also this square root Kissing map has some Wittgenstein formula and also reduction property. So let me briefly explain what's the issue in K-theory. So in K-theory, we can mimic the procedure introduced before. But we don't know how we can start because editing Gram didn't define some square root class in K-theory, K-group. So we define that starting point here. So we define square root K-theoretic square root Euler class using this formula. Here, this curly E is usual K-theoretic Euler class. So one difference is instead of using some analog of H, we use square root of determinant bundle. And the reason why we need to use 1 over 2 in K-theory is because if we want to if we want to have some well-defined class on this square root operation, then we need this coefficient. So the region is very different. So here is the reason why we need to do this twisting by square root of determinant bundle. So in case theory construction, actually this y tilde is some tau of quadratic bundles, quadric bundles. It's a quadric. So it's derived the principle actually. This is exactly equivalent to this structure shift in K-theory. So this is different from the K-theory, the cycle theory. So we don't really need this some analog of this H in the definition. But the problem is K-theory will class is not equal to each dual in general of the sign. Instead, they satisfy this condition with twisting. So this is why we need such twist in the definition. Do you have a question? Okay. So recall, so we are interested in moduli of shifts on X. So each in fancy language, the obstruction theory is described in this way. And as I said, by Huber and Thomas, this becomes obstruction theory on M. And set duality implies this has isomorphism from E to E dual shifted by 2, satisfied each dual is exactly itself in all these stories in derived category. But what we did is actually this derived object has realization in chain level. So our proposition is this E has resolution, the chain, chain complex of locally free shifts, where the middle term is O bundle, not S. So far we don't know which O, but later I will explain it. And first and last term is dual to each other, and morphisms are also dual to each other. Such that so this composition is also realized by chain map, this. So the EG corollary is the last two term becomes perfect obstruction theory of M. So we can do Baron Fantecchi or Litian's machinery, which says then we can have some immersed cone inside E. Note that E is isomorphic to E dual. To apply our machinery in previous section, I'll skip this proof. To apply our machinery in previous section, we need to check those two things. One is the middle bundle E must be SO bundle, not just SO bundle. And also cone constructed in the corollary here. This must be isotropic. The first is implied by Kao Gross Joyce result. They proved they constructed such isomorphism and whose square is isomorphism induced by zeta here. And for the second, we need to use Pantev, Poem, Pakin, Petrushi, and Bastet, Bravo, Bush, Joyce, and another work, Bravo, Bush, Joyce. The point is, the moduli space M has it's a classical truncation of some derived scheme with the minus two shifted symplectic structure. Then locally, so then Bravush Joyce describe the local structure of this moduli space, which induce this cone, local cone is isotropic. Since this is glued all the local cones, this also isotropic. Then we define virtual fundamental class by this formula. So this definition is depending on the choice of realization of obstruction theory. But we prove this is independent of realization of the obstruction theory. The proof is followed from the properties we introduced before. Well, for virtual structure shift, we also do we can also define this using this case theoretic scale to Gissing map, but we also need some twisting. Then with this twisting, then this twisted virtual structure shift is independent of resolution. Okay. So I'll explain torus localization first, and if it, there's some time remains, then I'll explain the proof. I'll explain the proof of this thing. Now let's assume our collabial fourfold has torus action, which preserves the holomorphic four-form. Then this torus also acts on moduli space M. Actually, so on the moduli space times X, it's proved by Caldararo that there is a universal universal shift. And Ricolfi proved there's a lifting action even on this universal universal shift, twisted shift. So our obstruction theory is also torus equivalent, and at fixed loci MT, we have a decomposition of our realization into these two factors, fixed part and moving part. Fixed part means non-zero weight, zero weight, and moving part is non-zero weight. So note that both fixed part and moving part in the middle term, they are SO bundle, because in moving term, if one has non-zero weight, then there must be a pair part. So this gives SO structure on EM. And since this is a reduction, automatically has SO structure. It's known that this fixed part is obstruction theory of MT, fixed part. So we can do the same procedure we introduced before to define each fundamental class like this. And we define a virtual the Euler class of a virtual normal bundle to be this. So this is defined using moving part, and this is defined using fixed part. So in case theory, we define in a similar way, so using fixed part. We define twisted virtual structure shift for fixed loci. And we also define Euler class of virtual normal bundle to be this formula using moving point. Then the localization formula is this. Virtual class divided by, sorry, maybe this, maybe this is scale, this need a scale root. So also previous this need a scale root. This is definition, so it's not a problem, but this denominator must be class we introduced in previous pages. Anyway, so this class divided by this class, if we push forward those things is exactly equal to our virtual class. But to make sense, this quotient, we have to invert some variables here. Okay. So I'll stop here. I need to one more page. Sorry. I want to stop here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, are there questions? So you can count also surfaces and so using your technique.
So
usually Gromov-Witten and calculate curves, but you have also you can count surfaces.
Thank you very much for the question. So the problem maybe, so we need to have this kind of obstruction theory. But at least I don't know if there's some interesting example which has this type of obstruction theory so far. So I don't know. Maybe if obstruction theory satisfies this condition, then definitely it works.
But this is it not automatic on Calabi-Yau 4-fold?
It's from Calabi-Yau 4-fold and sheaf theory, that's automatically true. But yeah. if we replace C2 surface here, then the second cohomology also may survive.
Yes. I'm sorry.
I don't
my know question is that. The sheaf supported on surfaces.
I see.
So Gromov-Witten, related to sheaves on supported on curves, but you can use this on also for some sheaves supported on surfaces, it seems. So, are there any calculation by physicists like that?
I can catch the point.
So in the case of Calabi-Yau threefold, physicists calculated a lot of numbers. Or mathematicians calculated. So are there similar thing by physicists?
Maybe Professor Toda knows better, but maybe I remember what he said when we meet in February. This invariant is more related to curve counting. Am I right?
You mean curve counting?
Yes, so this four-fold invariant produced by this machinery is more related to curve counting, not surface counting.
Sorry, maybe I can explain more. So, so in the threefold case, so here consider in threefold case, you can also consider the counting two-dimensional sieves inside the Calabi-Yau threefold, and it's generating sheaves. So this has to do with the so-called black hole entropy in physics, and there is a so-called August Minja Papa conjecture limiting this count with the counting curves inside the Calabi threefold. And in the Calabi fourfold case, so you can define the invariant using the his technique. But it's not clear what is whether there is some relation with this invariant and the curve counting on Calabi fourfold.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so are there more questions? No more questions? Professor Toda, do you have any question?
Maybe I have one technical question. So in your construction, I think you need resolution by three-term complex, right?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so for this, I think you need the at least quasi projectivity of your moduli space.
Right.
So, but in general, if you consider like moduli space of stable object, like which and stable object, so it's not clear whether the moduli space is projective or not. So it's just algebraic space.
Right, right.
So in that situation, so do you still have a way to construct the partial class?
I don't know.
I'm wondering whether you have some sort of intrinsic normal cone construction similar to Bayesian fantasy.
But yes, I don't know. At least if this is true, it has minus two shifted derived structure locally, right? Even in that case.
Yes, locally, yes. Mm. Locally, so you can construct that three-term complex, but the question is how you can view this.
Right. Maybe we should, so I've thought these things, I thought probably maybe we can semi-pocket obstruction theory techniques or not, but I don't know. Is it?
I see. Okay.
Okay. So are there more questions?
Is there construction related to the construction of the relative invariant of Calabian fourfold inside smooth anticanonical divisor, then there should be a relative invariant. So do you know the relation of your construction on this relative invariant?
So which relative invariant?
So consider a funnel fourfold, mm-hmm. funnel fourfold with smooth anticanonical divisor, then I think it is expected that there should be a some invariant takes a value in the cohomological DT invariant of this Calabi threefold. So do you know the relation of your construction on this?
So do you mean Fano threefold and Calabi fourfold?
Oh, sorry, Fano fourfold and Calabi threefold.
So, I don't know. Did I?
Okay.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. So this is kind of a logarithmic case. So logarithmic Calabian fourfold.
Ah, I see.
Yeah. Maybe you can extend to this case too. Okay. Are there more questions?
So at the beginning of your definition of C1 fourfold, why do you assume the vanishing of HI zero? For instance, can you also define it when the fourfold is the product of a Calabi threefold with an elliptic curve?
So, you mean this condition?
Yes.
Probably we can replace it to fix determinant condition, right? But the reason we take this instead of a fixed determinant condition is because somehow this some technical difficulty in this, but we can also replace this condition fixed determinant. In the case also work.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Yes.
How about the local Calabria fourfold? Can you do that in the same method or?
If that has a total section and if we collect compact supported sheaf, then we can use localization formula to define embed.
You mean the total space of Fano threefold? Total space of canonical bundle of on Fano threefold?
Yeah, for instance, yeah, in that example.
Okay, okay.
Are there more questions? If not, let's thank the speaker again.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So thank you also. So our next seminar will be in 2 weeks.
Oh, see you. See you then.
Okay, yeah.
Bye-bye.